Gaz and Ghouls, what's going on? Dr. Gonzo, oh boogie here again, back for another video, and this is my first video of October, so I'm real excited about this, because Halloween is my favorite holiday, and I usually spend all month long watching horror movies, and actually all month long on my channel, I want to post up videos showing you guys some of my favorite parts of my horror movie collection. And to start things off, I was going to show you guys my entire Friday the 13th collection. I have a lot of stuff to show here. The Friday the 13th films are some of my favorite horror movies ever. Actually, the Friday the 13th series, the first 8 original films by Paramount, are my favorite horror movie franchise or series, whatever you want to call it. And I usually watch these movies like twice a year. I usually watch all 8 of them during the summer, because, you know, they're like camp horror movies. I usually like to watch a lot of the like summer camp slasher films during the summertime, so I always watch the Friday the 13th films towards like the middle of the summer, I would say, and then also around this time of the year, around October and the fall time, I like to watch the Friday the 13th films too. So these are just some of my favorite horror movies to watch, and I've been watching them for a really long time. Back when I was like 13 and 14, my mom would let me rent them from the video store, so I just have a lot of nostalgia towards the Friday the 13th films too. They were some of the first horror movies that I really got big into, and they're still some of my favorite horror movies to watch to this day. But don't want to waste any more time, so I'm just going to get going and show you guys all the awesome stuff I have in my collection that is related to the Friday the 13th series. So actually, to start things off, I'm going to show you guys this DVD box set. Actually, I have a few Friday the 13th box sets, and as of now, actually don't have any of the Friday the 13th movies on Blu-ray. I used to, at one point, have the 2-packs that they put out on Blu-ray that came with, you know, part 1 and 2, and then 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. But I've actually sold those, and now that I found that there's a few of those that are like going for a lot of money on eBay now, like 80 to 100 bucks. I really wish I did hold on to those, but at the time I sold them because I had so many copies of the Friday the 13th movies on DVD, and I didn't really notice that much of a difference between the quality of the transfers between those ones and the ones on this box set here that I'm about to show. So I ended up selling them one day just because I needed some extra cash for some more movies. I regret that, but I will pick up the Friday the 13th movies on Blu-ray one of these days. But alright, let's move on to this awesome box set here. It's actually a really cool Friday the 13th box set. It's like limited edition. Mine is like 25,000 out of 50,000. And I know that this set, too, goes for a lot of money on eBay. I picked this up at a Dollar General, actually, for 25 bucks. I thought that was like, the best. This is, like, the coolest thing I've ever seen at the Dollar General, and I just thought that was an awesome deal on this. So, really happy about this. This comes with the first 8 Friday the 13th films in a pretty cool, like, kind of book box set thing. I'm not going to take anything out of the set because I'm trying to keep it in good condition, but you guys can basically see what's in it on the back here. It comes with like a replica hockey mask, which isn't quite big enough to actually wear for like a Halloween costume. It's more for like a display piece, I would think. And it comes with a cool book thing too, and some 3D glasses for the Friday the 13th Part 3 release. So this is a really cool DVD set. Really glad I was able to pick this one up for a really good price. Alright, so let's move on to some more Friday the 13th box sets. Next up, this is one of my favorite DVD box sets ever, and probably my favorite thing in my Friday the 13th collection, and this is the Crystal Lake to Manhattan box set. I actually picked this one up when it first came out back in the early 2000s, 2004, and that was like, you know, when I was still obsessed with the Friday the 13th films, so that was probably at the height of my obsession of these films, so this was just the perfect thing for me to pick up, and I just really like this box set. I like the way that it's laid out, and just everything about this box set I love. Just in case you guys haven't seen the artwork on the DVDs, I'll show you guys real quickly, because I do think they're pretty cool, even though they're not as cool as as if they just use like the movie posters or something like that, but they're still kind of cool anyways. This is the Extras DVD. It's the Part 8 and 7 release. Part 5 and 6. And the artwork on these ones are sort of similar to the older DVD releases, I would say. Then 3 and 4, my two favorite Friday the 13th films. And 1 and 2. So just a really awesome box set there. I know that this box set, again, is kind of hard to get to and a little bit pricey, but I think, in my opinion, that it's the best Friday the 13th box set we've gotten so far. Alright, so this is the last Friday the 13th box set, and this is the Jason Slasher Collection released by New Line Cinema, and these are the other Jason movies, the ones that came out after the original Paramount series. These are the ones made by New Line Cinema in the late 90s and early 2000s. And I don't like these movies as much as the original Friday the 13th movies, but I do think some of these are pretty good. Actually, Jason X is pretty good. It's a really cheeseball movie, Jason in space, but I'm a huge sci-fi horror fan, so for some reason that works for me. Actually, me and my buddy Joel went and saw that movie in theaters when we were really young, when it first came out, so I always remember that. And Jason Goes to Hell, I actually think is the worst out of all the Friday the 13th movies. It's just the whole mythology they put behind him, I think, is really stupid and pointless. And just everything about that movie, I think, was done wrong. I mean, Friday the 13th movies aren't hard to pull off. You just got to put some people in the woods and have Jason kill them off. And they really just, I think, went a little bit too far off with Jason Goes to Hell. It just doesn't feel or seem like a Friday the 13th movie. And of course, you got Freddy vs. Jason, which is just awesome to have Freddy and Jason in the same movie. But I would have to say, when that first came out and I was a lot younger, I thought that movie was awesome, just the coolest thing around. And recently, when I rewatched it, I guess the movie's kind of lost its hype for me. And I don't think it's as cool of a movie anymore, but, you know, you can't go wrong with Freddy vs. Jason. So this is a nice little box set with these. I actually think it's like a decent companion to go with the other Friday the 13th box set. It's good stuff there. So let's move on to the last part of my Friday the 13th DVD collection. I have a few of the Friday the 13th movies separate on DVD. Actually, the first four, because these are actually my favorite looking releases out of that have been put out for the Friday the 13th movies, because they use the original movie posters. I really wish that all 8 of the Friday the 13th movies got DVD releases with the original movie posters, because the original Friday the 13th movie posters are some of the coolest horror movie posters ever. They're what made me rent them when I was younger, because the posters look so cool on the VHS covers, which I will get to after this. Let's just finish off the DVDs here. This is Friday the 13th, the original classic here. It's got like a cool holographic cover here. I actually think it has like the same mask design on it as the Crystal Lake, the Manhattan set. So this release must have came out around that time. But underneath the slip cover thing is just the regular copy of Friday the 13th, the old Paramount release. But I really love these releases. Again, like I said, with the original movie poster. And I really love the widescreen border that's red. It just looks so cool. Like the black, white, and red design on these, just so cool. Just some of my favorite looking DVDs out of like every DVD ever made. I just really love the way these look. Friday the 13th. Friday the 13th Part 2. Friday the 13th Part 3. Which this is one of my all-time favorite Friday the 13th movies. This is one of the best, in my opinion. The first one with Jason in the hockey mask, of course. But my favorite Friday the 13th movie is Friday the 13th, the final chapter, Friday the 13th, Part 4. This is definitely my favorite one. I just think the characters in this movie are the most likable out of any of the Friday the 13th movies. So that that I think that does a lot for the movie, because a lot of the times in the Friday the 13th movies, you don't even really care too much about the people in the movie. But this one, I actually like most of the characters in this one. And I just think this is the best one. Just my favorite Friday the 13th movie to watch. Great stuff there. So that was it for the DVD collection. But I do have all 8 of the Friday the 13th movies on VHS. I have shown these off in a video before, but that was from a long time ago, so I figured I would show them off again in this video. So let's just go through these. And again, like I mentioned before, basically renting these movies on VHS when I was younger is what got me into them, kind of based on the cover designs. I just always thought they looked really appealing for some reason when I was in the video store. So I used to rent these movies back when I was really young, like 13, 14, and they would like scare the crap out of me. And like nowadays I could put these movies on to help me go to sleep because I've seen them so many times. So, but alright, let's take a look at these. This is the release for Friday the 13th. This is an old school Paramount release. Really cool stuff here. Friday the 13th Part 2. Try to give you guys a look at the artwork on the back of these two. Part 3. Part 4. Again, this is my favorite Friday the 13th movie. And let's move on to Part 5. And I actually like Part 5. Actually, my copy of this on tape, the cover art is a little damaged, so I'd really like to upgrade this one to a better quality tape one of these days, but I'm just glad to have it anyway. But I actually really like Part 5. I know a lot of people don't like this one because it has like a copycat Jason on it. Sorry for anyone who hasn't seen it, but it has a copycat Jason in it. And I guess that kind of ruins the movie for some people, but this feels like a Friday the 13th movie. Actually, the first 4 Friday the 13th movies have this like very similar vibe and style and quality to them that a lot of the later ones don't really have exactly. And I would say the 5th one still sticks really strictly to that style that was held up within the first 4 Friday the 13th movies. And I think this is a fun one, too. Some of the characters in this one are a lot of fun, too. Part 6, which is another fun Friday the 13th movie, Jason Lives. This one, Jason gets brought back to life by, like, lightning, classic Frankenstein style, and this is just a really fun movie. I think probably one of the funnest Friday the 13th movies. I used to rent this one a lot when I was younger, and I used to rent Part 8 a lot, too, when I was younger. Alright, this is Part 7, The New Blood. This is another older Paramount release on VHS. I really love these old VHS tapes. Just awesome stuff. Really love the cover art design on this one. I used to rent this one a lot when I was younger too. Part 6, 7, and 8 I used to rent probably more than the other ones for some reason. I think basically just because the cover arts on those ones are really appealing. So good stuff here. This is kind of like Jason versus Carrie. Jason versus a girl with, like, you know, like, power, like, mind powers, whatever you call it. I can't even think of the word right now, but this is a pretty fun one, even though it's probably one of my least favorites in the whole Friday the 13th series nowadays. Then last up here for the tapes is Jason Takes Manhattan. And this was actually my favorite one to rent when I was younger because the cover art is just so awesome on this one. So I probably rented this one the most when I was younger. And to this day, it's still one of my favorite Friday the 13th movies. I would say the first 4 Fridays are my favorite in kind of like a weird order. And then after that, it would probably be Part 8. I just really like this one for some reason. Alright, so that's it for the DVDs and VHSs, but I do have, like, some random Friday the 13th memorabilia that I figured I would show you guys. Actually, one thing that I forgot to grab is actually an autograph from Kane Hodder that I have hanging on my wall. So that's pretty cool. I actually sent him a comic book, a Friday the 13th comic book that I drew when I was really young, and he sent me an autograph back in the mail. So that was the first autograph I ever got from anybody who's like in horror movies. Just the first autograph I ever got in general. All right, so let me just go through this stuff. I have a couple of Friday the 13th Jason figures. First off, here is this awesome Jason figure released by NECA. This is in their like classic video game series that they've been putting out, or the retro video game series. And actually, the Jason figure was the first one they put out in that series, and in my opinion, it's the best one, because a lot of those figures just look like kind of cheap, you know, because they're just all painted one solid color. But this one I thought was just the coolest looking one out of all of them, so this was always my favorite out of those figures they put out, even though I also picked up the Predator one they put out. That one's pretty cool too, I guess. But this is actually the original one was released at like Comic-Con whenever this came out, and that one goes for like a lot of money. But they re-released it like last year, I think around Halloween time, and I went to Toys R Us and picked it up. And the re-release is really cool. It plays like the music from the game when you open it. There we go. So that's really cool. Don't want to waste the battery on it, so I won't keep it open too long. But the artwork on the inside is really cool too, based on the Friday the 13th video game on the original Nintendo system. The Jason figure is awesome too. Comes with like Mrs. Voorhees' head and I think like an axe there. Just a really cool figure here. This is probably my favorite action figure in my whole collection. Alright, next up here, I just had this little tiny Jason keychain. This is like a Funko Pop keychain. I picked this up last year around like Christmas time. Pretty cool. And I have a couple random like book things here, I guess. First off here is a old school copy of Fangoria from like 1981 or 2, something like that. And it has Friday the 13th, it's from 1981, and it has Friday the 13th Part 2 featured on the cover. That's actually Mrs. Voorhees' head in a refrigerator, one of my favorite scenes from that movie. Great stuff there. And then last for this video, and last for my Friday the 13th collection, is this weird Friday the 13th book that I've picked up at a thrift store one time. This is actually like a young adult novel. And this is part of, like, a Friday the 13th series. I guess there's also, like, a Nightmare on Elm Street book series like this, too. But, this is actually pretty cool. It's, like, officially Friday the 13th licensed, too. And this is, like, Mother's Day. I think this is the first book in the series. And, of course, it probably has something to do with Miss Voorhees. So, really cool stuff here. Love this book. Just thought it was cool. I would love to pick up more of these, because I know these are, like, hard to find. When I picked this up, I checked eBay, and I think these are going for, like, about, like, $20 each. So, I always check I'm always looking at thrift stores, and I always check the book section and stuff, but I actually haven't found any more of these. Really cool stuff there. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, definitely give this video a big thumbs up or leave a comment or subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.
Morgan! Do you hear Morgan? again.